This is a machine I designed myself. This whole concept was mine, all mine to begin with. I got parts from a lathe, and I had somebody weld this frame down here, and then I made this, had somebody make these slide things and this lead screw and stuff, and this is has a hydraulic motor and a hydraulic pump, and then it's has a chain drive in there. Hippie building method either involves going and tearing down an old building, old house or something, and getting used lumber, or getting scrap lumber someplace, labor intensive like adobe walls and stuff like that. I always wanted to come up with some kind of some method that you could make build something fairly inexpensively, sort of a do-it-yourself. So that's the reason why I came up with that machine. And with all the parts are brand new, and I had to get somebody to weld the stuff together, and somebody do a few machining of a few of the parts. And but with all that, I think it only cost me about $1,400-$1,500 to do it, to make it. And they make stuff like this. This comes off, and I can make these 3 feet long, maybe even longer than that. But take them and laminate them together like shingles and staple them. You could build up to an inch thick or more, as long as it doesn't get too heavy. And I maybe put a little glue. I use that little bit of that tight bond glue, that tight bond water proof glue. And then I take them and staple them onto these would be horizontal pieces. I use that one of those air compressor staplers to do that, and then you can nail them or something to the walls or to the roof. And well, I'm thinking I could make structures with curved walls. Can make furniture out of this. Can make maybe chairs with laminated wood chairs. I don't know what all. You could do just about anything with that, I guess. But that's. Take them, staple them together. Just overlap them, and they have to be set someplace and dry, because they'll shrink and tend to curl up, so they lay them like one on top of the other like that, with the curves going against each other. And you can make these as big as you want to, make them into panels, and then I staple them onto pieces like this. You could space these as far apart as you want to, and then they're stapled onto that with the bigger staples, one of those air staple guns. And then I'll probably need to, I spray them with linseed oil and turpentine. I'll probably put several layers of that on there. You can put a number of things, put tar on them or put some kind of resin on them or something like that to keep the water from affecting them. This is a shed roof I just made. It has some imperfections in it, but that's what I was going for, and I'm looking for the kind of the hippie look. The shed I made about 2 years ago, I used a different method. I sliced these shingles on a arbor press.